skipping. Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging. Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete. Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging.
Charging. 4, 3,
charging.
16th of July, 3302. Demands of supply. Commanders are advised to search within nebulae for rocky or high metal content worlds with a composition of between 66.5 and 99.1% rock, and 8.9 and 33.5% metal, with 0% ice. Temperatures between 194 and 451 Kelvin should be sought. To narrow the field, commanders should also seek bodies with gravity between 0.06 and 0.3 Gs. This text is taken from Barnacle Search Criteria, a recent publication from the Canon Interstellar Research Group. Commentators are divided on what impact, if any, this information has on the increasingly volatile situation in and around the MROPE system. But many agree that if the barnacles are being viewed as a finite resource, the Canon's data may serve to diffuse tensions, at least temporarily. The proposal of the criteria is believed to have followed a private conference between Dr. Arcanon and Professor Cora Schur, director of the Palin Institute. Dr. Arcanon commented, "We must not let the drums of war drown out the fact that the stated positions of the Federation and the Empire are, upon review, far from irreconcilable." This has been Computer Pete reporting for Radio Sidewinder News. Lots of people are looking for metal alloys right now. The Empire is looking for barnacles. And of course, people are looking to help the galaxy's favorite cyborg, Chuck, get back on the move with his station. Let us know if you find a barnacle out there, Commander. Fly safe.
Warning, temperature critical.
Bank of Sales. Trust the Bank of Sales with your hard-earned credits.
Thank you.
charging.
Thank you. our galaxy, in all its vastness, is itself as alive as we beings who call it home. Still, there are many among us who slowly poison our systems and their people. These malevolent monsters beget a corrosive darkness into the essence of this awesome place. It is the mission of Northern Light to rid the galaxy of these evils through the strategic engagement of those who seek to corrupt it. Northern Light shines with the authority of Alioth to the farthest reaches of the galaxy to protect it against the beasts looming deep in darkness. Go to northernlight.club to learn how you can join. Northern Light, light from darkness.
The galaxy is becoming a very dangerous place to operate in. Political and economic turmoil, coupled with rapid, unregulated growth in private industry, means that your business interests are under increasing threat. In times like these, you need to know someone has your back. You need the Diamond Frogs. The Diamond Frogs are a premier private security firm, offering galaxy-class risk assessment services and 24/7 logistical and operational support. With on-demand services working around the clock, we guarantee that your organizational needs will be met, no questions asked. But you don't have to take my word for it. Just listen to these very real testimonials from very real people.
The Diamond Frogs helped us out when our organization ran into problems with our supply line. They were able to address everything in a timely and professional manner, and our customers could not be happier with our now uninterrupted supply of affordable labor.
We suffered months of constant harassment, with no one to turn to. Thankfully, we hired the Diamond Frogs. They responded with professionalism and courtesy, eliminating our pest problem and allowing us to get back to business.
Yeah, I had a falling out with an old business partner of mine. The Diamond Frogs helped me kill it dead.
Hi-ho, Carmelo Froik here, founder and CEO of the Diamond Frogs, and I can personally guarantee you that we will solve whatever problem you can throw at us. Probably. We've got a good fighting chance. But we'll do it with all the professionalism and diligence you can expect out of a pack of mercenaries, privateers, a couple of goat farmers. No greater good, no just cause. The galaxy calls for wet work, and nobody does wet like a frog.
Gentlemen, I am brave enough.
4, 3, 2, 1.
shift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging.
Greetings and thank you for tuning in, Commander. You're listening to Radio Sidewinder News. Ending in victory once again for the EG pilots, the third heat began, with the factions being tasked with finding precious gem salvage and bringing them back to the Meropis system. The catch for the final round was that the event organizers refused to reveal the precise whereabouts of the salvage site, instead only giving a cryptic alphanumeric signal that had to be decoded before groups could progress. It was quickly discovered by the research teams of each of the top three powers that the salvage was to be found in the Mikey system. In just over a day, the EG pilots once again managed to close out their quota in the event, sweeping all three rounds of the games and securing their place as the definite winner. While we were extending our congratulations to the EG pilots, their captain, Shade Gustavsky, gave us a brief victory statement. Hi guys, it was an amazing 6 weeks of games. We would like to thank all pilots for their support. Without them, the victory would have been impossible. The games united many pilots and made us stronger. It was also a great competition thanks to our worthy opponents. So good luck, commanders, and may there be freedom among the stars. The Social LEU Progressive Party came in third place. Their leader, Kankrovantas, gave us this statement as the EG pilots secured their victory. Fellow commanders, I can't thank all of you enough for the last couple of weeks of the Dangerous Games. It's been a terrific and wonderful experience, like the many others our community decides to participate in. We feel honored and proud to have been able to bring such an excellent group of explorers, traders, and general pilots into the mix. To all the truly independent pilots of the galaxy, the ones that wanted to say explorers matter, we are also here. We came as the underdog, as the last faction to make it into a competition designed for hundreds of pilots, while we are not even a dozen. Today, we can proudly celebrate together an astounding achievement of third place out of six competitors. This wouldn't have been possible without the dedication and collaboration displayed during the first community goal, which gained the subsequent support from the Border Coalition and Interstellar Communist Union. It was then clear that SEP was making ripples with its message through the galaxy. Today, we congratulate the EG pilots, who won the game squarely and fairly in a stunning performance all the way through. And so did Galvanos in their close second position. To them, thanks for an exciting competition and sportsmanship. We will now be looking to see the kind of new power that will be formed from this, and we are confident there will be many other ways and channels we will continue to try and voice the needs for exploration and pushing more developments geared for exploration out of the bubble, and regarding alien civilizations. Rest assured that our labor does not stop here. May the LEU star shine bright for us all. The second place power, the Galactic Cooperative, was unable to leave as a comet directly, but members of their faction were seen shaking hands with the other competitors and wishing the victors well in the future. Many of their conversations went quite along the same lines as the sentiments shared by their opposite numbers.
Friendship,
what is truly amazing
charging.
Is the fact that two of the other Dangerous Games factions, the Border Coalition and the Interstellar Communist Union, dropped their candidacy altogether and threw their support in behind SEP. But even with the Menite Piscium Pact in place, EG pilots were completely unstoppable. Congratulations go out to the winners and all of the participants of the Dangerous Games. We look forward to seeing the power that is formed in the galaxy in the wake of this event. If you're out there looking for a power to be a part of, check out the Radio Sidewinder crew, a minor faction based in the system of Tago. You can find more information at inara.cz/wing/568, or you can join our Discord server at radiosidewinder.com. As always, fly smart and fly safe, Commander. This has been Commander Arbitration, reporting for Radio Sidewinder News.
Zorgon Peterson Hall is a small freighter with a big heart. Want to go trading? An 8-ton cargo hold makes it the perfect vessel to start your trading career. Want to go exploring? Jump bridge 27 light years makes it a good exploration vessel, great for quick relocation. Even giving it enough room to fit in an SRV. The Hauler, Zorgon Peterson, the ship with a big heart. You'll never forget your first Hauler.
Departure authorized. Rogue Niner.
Shields offline. Hull integrity compromised. Landing gear deployed. Shields online.
Freedom is to craft your own destiny. Freedom
is liberty. Fly free. Fly Alliance.
Landing confident engaged. Access corridor is clear.
Sometimes you gotta go back to actually move forward. I don't mean to go back to some fuel, scans, or events. I mean to go back and see where you came from, where you've been, how you got here. See where you're going. I know there are those that say you can't go back. Yes, you can. You just have to target the right system. The Lacon asks the Explorer,
three,
live in the moment.
Two, one, engage.
They say, home is where the heart is. Fools. Home is where the prophets are. Where the adventure lurks. Where the vast sights of the unknown nebulae stretch into the darkness. Home. Home is freedom. Freedom is to chart your own path. Freedom is to craft your own destiny.
Freedom
is liberty. Fly free. Fly Alliance.
This message is endorsed by Prime Minister Redmond Mahon. Independent worlds for a progressive future.
3, 2, 1, engage. Frameshift drive charging. Charging.
Thank you.
Alpha Galnet News Update.
This is a Galnet News report for the 16th of July, 3302. Jacques Barnacle search. The discovery of Jacques' station has prompted many commanders to load up on meta-alloys and start the long trek to EAL-PRU RS-T-D3-94. One group that has already made it has begun searching the area for barnacles. If the structures are found, they could provide Jacques with meta-alloys needed to fix the station. Some commanders remain skeptical, arguing that the barnacles are engineered and won't be found in the system, but they haven't stopped the search from going ahead. For many, it is not a question of if barnacles were found. It is a question of when. One of the searchers said, "It makes sense there would be barnacles out here. The system has many of the conditions required. But searching for them is a big job. Any assistance from pilots in the area is welcome." This has been Robot Rachel reporting for Radio Sidewinder News. Today's story was brought to us by Commander Blue Wolf. You know, Jacques and I go way back to Topaz. You can ask him yourself. After all, he never forgets a face. I certainly hope he hasn't forgotten this one. I certainly hadn't forgotten his. Well, anyway, fly safe, Commander. And do make sure you have enough fuel to complete your journey.
This hour of Radio Sidewinder is sponsored by Conga Ale, the most refreshing brew in the galaxy. If you're looking for a deep, satisfying flavor, look no further than Conga Ale, made from the finest Conga hops and brewed to perfection. Conga Ale is always satisfying. Try Conga Ale today, and remember, be responsible. Don't drink and fly.
Engage.
charging.
Landing complete. Ship secured. Welcome.
charging. Fuel skip disengaged.
Please ensure that they keep pads clear and enter hangars once completing transactions. This announcement is brought to you by Quality OP Consultants, bringing efficiency to your
airport. Fuel scooping.
This is a Radio Sidewinder Friendship Galactic Service announcement. Charging. Hello, Commanders. Your friends here at Radio Sidewinder are here to keep you company in your long journeys among the stars. But we don't just want to see you happy and entertained. We also want to see you safe and wealthy. As you undoubtedly know, one of the most dangerous and annoying things that could happen when you're supercruising your way to a route is being interdicted by some good-for-nothing, low-life scumbag of a pirate in his flying bucket of bolts. We just wanted to do our duty to all our faithful listeners and be sure to remind you that it is dangerous out there. Being interdicted means that the low-life pirate is destabilizing your frameshift drive and forcing you to drop out of supercruise in order to leave you vulnerable. Whenever you find yourself in your cockpit with your alarms blaring and your ship sliding all over out of control, just remember, always aim for the escape vector your computer sets out. It will always keep you and your cargo safe and alive. This has been Radio Sidewinder with a Galactic Service announcement. Travel safe, Commanders.
4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Freeze dried ice cream, powdered lasagna. Guess I could go with mashed potatoes again.
Isn't there something better to eat?
It's the same old bland food giving you a case of space madness. Here in Ochoa, we're proud to say we've the best and hottest chili peppers in the galaxy.
Ochoa.
If you're craving flavor, come see us at Roddenberry Gateway in Ochoa and try a pepper as dangerous as you are.
Blindness
or death, keep away from eyes. Do not feed the children unless they're being very naughty.
Engage.
Charging. Charging.
Thank you.
approach to landing pad 09er. Docking request revoked. Landing permission granted. You are clear for approach to pad 09er.
Shields offline. Hull integrity compromised.
Contact. Ship secured.
The following is a Radio Sidewinder news report for the 22nd of July, 3302, provided by Commander Telemar. The Kanan crew have been extremely busy this week, following the discovery of the unknown probes last month. The research team have been hard at work trying to figure out what these things are. Here's a summary of the events thus far. Artifacts have been found surrounding the Merope system for almost a year now. Wait a minute. What system was
fuel
that?
Scooping.
That's right.
Merope.
Spelled Mike Echo Romeo Oscar Papa Echo. It's not pronounced Merope, and definitely not Merope. It's pronounced Merope. And if you don't believe me, simply consult its spelling in the Intergalactic Phonetic Alphabet. Okay, back to the report. Apologies, Telecom. Reports state that artifacts can be found in a 120 light-year sphere around Merope, and that they should be treated with extreme caution, as they carry a threat level 4. Commanders who have found the artifacts state they scan their ships. Scientists from the Kanan Institute tested their theories and found that the artifacts were taking scans of their ships and transmitting the data. In recent months, these things have been spotted in Tau Ceti as well. This was followed by the discovery of unknown probes being transported in heavily armed convoys throughout the bubble of civilization. These probes have distinctive features from the artifacts, but they also share many similarities. Many theories have been bandied about regarding these objects. One claims the probes are in fact fully grown artifacts. Another claims they are Halsey's ancient architects. And one crazy, some say, tinfoil hat man theory comes from a Tau Ceti woman who claimed to be married to one for the last 3 months. She was reported to say, "All these guys in dark flight suits came to our house in the middle of the night and took my probe away. He is such a sweet being. The feds took him. I want him back. They can't do this." Yeah, I'm not sure quite what to make of that. But it hasn't been a dead end for Kanan. This week, Commander Ricardo had a breakthrough concerning the probes. After scanning one, his ship's power was disabled and it was forcefully shoved away. The probe then began to glow and sing to him. When news of this reached the scientists, they were able to replicate the behavior. The singing was recorded and analyzed to reveal a hidden message embedded in the audio. Here is what was heard. Theorizing the Kanan. This is leading people outside of Kanan to make their own predictions. Reports of rogue commanders attacking scientists in the Merope system have led to a level of subterfuge and privacy. When asked by us why they were attacking members of Kanan, these commanders shot at us too. In response to this recent upturn in alleged alien activity, some of the citizens of the Empire have begun to take a keen interest in the phenomena. A spokesperson for the Internal Nationalist Foundation of Interstellar Language, a small group of Imperial linguists, said the following.
That's my dear boy.
Ship restraints retracted. Access corridor is clear.
They have their reasons, which are undoubtedly sinister, I'm sure. We at the Institute only hope the Jark recorded singing so we prepare it to join the probe.
Could there be a link between the probes and poor Jack stranded out in deep space? He did report the singing. So maybe there is more to be found out there other than rum. We'll let you know more as the story develops. I'm Cole Glider, and you're listening to Radio Sidewinder.
3, 2,
you have an overwhelming desire to explore. Perhaps the answer lies in your DNA. The adventure gene is carried by roughly 1 in 4 humans. Commanders with this gene are adventurous and are less restricted by boundaries. Risks, and they may get sudden urges to explore. But before you can act on the urge to explore,
fuel scooping,
you will need the tools to make that exploration possible.
Frameship drive charging.
Introducing Diamondback Explorer by Lakon Spaceways. With a jump range of over 34 light years and a cargo capacity of up to 52 tons, the Diamondback Explorer is ideal for fast transport.
2, 1, engage.
Buy a Diamondback Explorer from Lakon Spaceways. Exploring, it's in our DNA.
Warning, temperature critical. Fuel scooping. Frameship drive charging.
Charging.
scooping. Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging.
Time ago that we sat across the stars. We didn't know what to expect, but the bonds of our brotherhood held us together. We made ourselves a home, swore to protect it, and more came to join our cause. They came from every corner of the galaxy to fight for something they believed in. Every trade, every profession, joined together for something bigger than themselves, here, at our side. I call upon you once more, as your ally, as your friend. Stand at our side, for what you believe is right. We are stronger together. We will not bend. We will not break. We will succeed.
We are Exo.
Rise up now. Never surrender.
Charlie, Oscar. Comms link established. Dock here at your own
radio. The
Eastern
Company understands the nature of it. Losses and drop profit margins. These are things the East India Company does not understand. In business, that means stronger and better trade. A workforce of slave labor that works off its debts like a good imperial citizen. We have the most diverse corporate portfolio in the cosmos. Do we even know what that means? We don't. We're too busy counting all these credits we got from Kim. Our motto is Sequoia Steps. Follow the stars. We are the East India Company.
Thank you.
Charlie Oscar Oscar, Federal Flight Control Channel open. Observe docking protocol if you wish to land. Permission authorized. You are clear for approach to pad 40. Docking request cancelled. Landing permission granted. You are clear for approach to pad 40. Docking request revoked. Permission authorized. Assigned to landing pad 40.
Landing gear deployed.
Engage.
This is a Galnet News freelance report for 22 July 3302. A year of buckyball racing. The Buckyball Racing Club was formed 1 year ago to provide a schedule of races involving a wide variety of pilots. In its first year, the club hosted a total of 28 races, and to celebrate, it is hosting one of its craziest yet. The Bucky Bubble. Commemorating the club's most famous race, the A-Star Challenge. The Bucky Bubble starts at Lomas Station in the Wolf 359 system. Racers will navigate a route that passes through 60 systems, loosely resembling the shape of a buckyball molecule. Pilots are invited to join the chaos from the 23rd of July to the 7th of August. This Galnet freelance report was provided by Commander Senna. This is Robot Rachel reporting for Radio Sidewinder. I only have one question. Which commander will be taking me along? I hear reports of those crazy Bucky Ballers having outrageous parties. I don't want to miss out on the fun. I may not be the biggest sports fan, but if you buy me a drink, You can do all the buckyballing you want.
Galnet News transmissions are sponsored in part by Bank of Sales. Trust the Bank of Sales with the hard work.
Oscar, be aware
where the fire
restrictions are in place in this sector.
Isn't there something better to eat? It's the same old plan to get in the case of Spears Madness. You're an Ojong. You're proud to say you're the best and hottest chili peppers in the galaxy. If you're craving flavor, come see us at Roddenberry Gateway in Ojong. The chili pepper is as dangerous as you.
Disturbed employment or death. Wake them up. Do not feed the children unless they're being very naughty.
way.
Flight assist off. Flight assist on. Landing gear deployed.
Frameship drive charging.
fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete. Frameshift drive charging. Fuel scoop disengaged.